soil moisture sensors. Is it really worth it? Today, everybody is speaking about soil moisture sensors, but what is it for? And more importantly, is it a depreciable investment? If you want to know the answer to this question, stay with me in this video. We will first explain what a humidity sensor is. This is a probe that determines the volumetric water content of soil, electrical conductivity, and the temperature of it. To get a better idea, this is a kind of tube that we are going to bury into our farm, and it has sensors at different depths. Normally, the sensors are every 10 centimeters, and we can purchase different size of probes depending on the depth of our root system in our crop. For example, if we have trees with a very deep root system, we can install sensors up to 1.2 meters length. But if we have a root system in our crop that is smaller, we can install, for example, 30 centimeter sensors. And what is the use of this information? The first thing we are going to know is how much water there is in our soil and how it is distributed in the profile of the soil. We are also going to have information on when this quantity reaches the limit of field capacity or the permanent wilting point that I had already explained to you in a previous video. You can click on the link here. This information will allow us to take many decisions regarding irrigation management, length and frequency, such as the moment to start the pump. We can tell to our control unit to start the irrigation pump whenever the water percentage reaches a certain value. When to stop the pump. Likewise, we can tell to our control unit to stop the pump whenever the probe sends us a certain humidity value at X depth. If the soil content on the ground is too high and we have to do a washing irrigation, also can be and information received by the probe. As you can see, there is a lot of information that we are going to receive. But on top of everything, there are a lot of decisions that we can take and make based on that information. For example, did you know that if we exceed the field capacity and the soil is saturated on water, the root activity of the plant will be reduced and it becomes in a lower water suction rate. That is to say, when we have more water on the soil, the plant absorbs less water. Amazing, huh? Okay, I understand that all this kind of information is not easy to interpret, because in the end, what we are going to have are graphics. That way, we always recommend to have the support of an agronomist or some technical advice coming from someone capable of understanding them and drawing conclusions. It is also a matter of getting used to work with them. As with everything, the more time you spend with the probe in your farm, the better you will understand the performance of your crops based on the information received by the probe. But believe me, if you want to have a full control of your crops and reduce as much as possible the wastewater, fertilizer, the pumping energy, so any volume of water that isn't wasted isn't pumped either, and avoid also the pollution of the soil, the definitive solution is the humidity probe. And now, if you want to know how to install a humidity sensor, Follow me.
Here we are. We have come to the countryside to show you how to install the sensor in the field. But first of all, I would like to put you in context. We are on a newly planted pistachio nuts farm of the variety Kerman. The total surface of the farm is around 7 hectares and the type of soil is a sandy clay soil more or less. A while ago, this farmer never considered to have any crop on this farm because of the leakage of water. Just to have an idea, the average precipitation in this area did not arrive to more than 350 millimeters more or less, while he can obtain from his well around 150 millimeters per year as well. And the needs of the pistachio are surrounding the 700 or 750 millimeters per season. As you can see, the water margin is quite tight. But this farmer made his calculation and decided to go forward. To achieve his goal, he installed a subsurface drip irrigation system together with an automated control system. And now is the moment to install the moisture sensors. All these elements will allow him to have total control over the irrigation system and reduce as much as possible the wasted water. Indeed, he expects to have nice yields in this farm now. Just imagine, he did change from one situation in which he had no crop in this farm to another one in which he expects to have nice incomes from this orchard. And let's see now how to install the sensors. The first step is to determine how many sensors we need to install in our farm. And there are three parameters that will help us to do that. The first one is the size of the farm. If our farm is quite small, we can eventually install a single sensor and it will be representative of the total surface of the farm. But instead of that, if our farm is too big, we will need to consider to install many sensors. In this case, we will install only one. The second one is the crop. If we have different crops in our farm with different needs in water, we will need to install at least one sensor for every type of crop. And the third one is the type of soil. If we have different texture in our soil in our farm, we will need to install one sensor for every type of soil. The second step is to decide the location of the sensor at the macro and micro level. In terms of macro level, we need to consider an area that is representative of the average of the farm. That means we did not take the higher point on the farm that will receive most commonly less water from the irrigation as well as from rainfall, and we will neither choose the lower point on the farm that will receive most commonly more water either from the irrigation system than from the rainfall. In terms of micro level, we need to choose one tree that is also representative of the average on the farm. That means we will not choose the most vigorous one and neither the less vigorous of them. Perfect! We did choose this area because it's the most representative of the farm. It's not the higher side of the farm, neither the lower. And in this area, we think that this tree is the most representative one of all of them. Now we will speak about the tools and materials we will use. The first one is the radio terminal. This terminal will be connected to the sensor and will send the signal to the control unit. The second one is the sensor itself with all the cable that should be connected to the terminal. And the only tool we'll use in this case is this auger to make the hole. Okay, the first thing we will need to do is a hole in order to find where is the drip line. And to determine where is the dripper, we have a dripper just here. So we did measure 75 centimeters, that is the space in between drippers, and we did determine the next dripper will be here, okay? Then we did take 20 centimeters away from the dripper and 60 centimeters away from the tree. That will give us a place in which we will have the sensor on the wet bulb, and also in the future will be on the root system of the tree as well.
We dig the hole on the selected point. After that, we need to introduce the sensor very carefully until the end. And then we will prepare a mixture of fine soil, fine earth, and water. This mixture will help us to fill all the spacing between the sensor and the soil. Just consider that to perform well, to give us a good reading of the humidity on the soil, the sensor should be in total contact with the earth. Then we connect the cable to the emitter and we fix the emitter on the pole.
And now, thanks to the subsurface drip irrigation system, the automated control, and the humidity sensors, this farmer is ready to grow profitable pistachios in his farm. A farm he used to think it was unable to grow anything. If you have a farm and you are interested in to get advice on how to improve your yields, just do like this farmer does. Send us an email, and our team of specialists will visit you to offer you advice. And your farm could be the starring of our next video.